them.
Yeah.
I think the welcome is gone. You know, if the message was clear, if you guys were all together with a single message, and you said, okay, you know what, we've been here, we've occupied, we've stayed at our point, now let's take it somewhere else and keep fighting it, but doing it in a different way, then I think people would respect it. But it's just going on and on and on and on, and now it's to where it's...
Kind of the point, going on and on. Nobody's going to care if you back away and it's no longer...
But you don't have to back away. You can still continue to fight, you're just doing it in a different way.
Right, from where nobody will notice or care? Like,
there are people fighting issues around the world all the time, and they are noticed, but they're not doing it in the way that you're doing it. You guys are noticed. Okay, people know who you are. They know what you guys are doing, but now you need to look at doing it in a different way that's still going to have an impact.
Didn't accomplish anything by backing down.
You're not backing down. You're continuing to fight. You're just changing the way that you're doing it.
Well, there's nothing wrong with camping there.
I can't think of a better way to do this than this right now.
I mean, for once, people can assemble.
But that's the argument. Okay. For you guys, there might not be anything wrong with camping there, but you've got thousands, tens, hundreds of thousands of other people that do see a problem with it, and that's where that's going to start biting you guys in the ass, because people are going to—they're not going to take it anymore. You know, and it's going to have a negative impact.
This is the laws of democracy. It's going to have a negative. Right to be here.
That's fine, but it's going to have a negative impact on what you guys are trying to achieve.
I agree that, you know. But I can't think of a better way to deal with it.
They're going
to
see it in the wrong way. You guys made a statement. Now you need to look at how you can change the way you're doing things to have a positive impact. Because, again, it's going to come back. It's going to bite you guys in the ass.
It's going
to
be negative impact.
What you guys are trying to do is just going to have a negative impact.
I totally agree. But what is the better option? Going from where? What kind of idea?
That's what you guys need to sit down and discuss, look at, and come up with other ideas. Every other
organization in
the world.
That's what they're doing. I mean, that's what all the committees are about. But until that point, you got to do what you can. That's right here.
But again,
no, I agree. I think you're in the right spirit.
You guys are going to take it to the point where you're not going to have that option anymore, because it's just going to go overboard.
That'll be a sad day for democracy and rights. That's for sure. That'll be a pretty sad day.
You know what? We've had a democracy here for hundreds of years.
It was a pretty brutal democracy for hundreds of years. It was pretty brutal.
Democracy only works when it is honest and people are well informed, and none of that is happening.
In my view,
assembling here.
Again, this is my opinion, but democracy is working. It needs some tweaking. There are some issues with it. It's not a total failure. There's other countries in the world that are a hell of a lot worse off than what we are right now. Look at what's going on in Thailand.
Make no mistake, though. I mean, our economy has been good. We've been spared from a lot of the effects that the Americans have and the Greeks and across the world. But that's not going to stay forever. Things are going to get worse here. Our economy can't keep going like this. What are we going to do then?
I agree 100%. Things need to change, but it's how you approach that change. And again, you guys have made a point. Everybody in this province, possibly the country, knows what's going on here, what you guys are doing.
That's a great
but
thing.
But now you need to look at how to do it differently. And
I'm right there with you.
If you think that staying here until you guys come up with the next step is going to be a positive thing, again, I think it's just going to bite you guys in the ass. You need to keep fighting if that's what you guys believe in. But I think you just need to do it in a different way. You need to say, okay, we've outgrown our time here. Let's move off. Let's stick together. Let's keep having these committee meetings. Let's discuss the change we can make, but do it in a different way. And
noted.
I think that'll lead to more positive change than sticking here.
I think that's a valid perspective, but like I said, until we get to that point where we have that idea, or where we can still have the effect that's being had right now, I don't see it personally a better option here. Other people might disagree. That's fair. I mean, that's why we're all discussing. That's why people discuss, but that's just my perspective.
So just as one last thing, when you guys go back, just really consider about the effect that you guys are having, because when you look at the newspaper and the news, it's not positive on you guys.
Well,
it's starting to turn negative, and again, very pro. It depends where you look at it. Like the Metro, the 24 Hours, they're just scathing against Occupy. A lot of the alternative medias are like gung-ho, keep it up. And alternative medias, it depends where you go. There's huge sites out here that have just as much traffic as mainstream.
There's even union support in it.
Union and support is a big one. Our unions have
CAW.
Our unions are a joke.
From the news, and that's bad, because like the news are bought and they're meant to twist the story.
But that's what people are reading. Bottom line, whether that's true or not, and man,
just follow
Fox
the money.
Fox News, I agree 100%. Okay?
Yeah.
Okay?
But people follow Fox News.
I've had my own issues with news as well. Okay. I always take it with a grain of salt. Yeah. But bottom line is you got to look at what the masses are reading, what they're watching on TV, yeah. and that's what they're getting.
What the people are getting.
No, you're right. But then look at Oakland. They say 7 grand. There's 100,000 people in the streets to anybody who's actually watching. To make a whole shebang out of it because a few guys in black garbs come around, which are suspicious in their entirety. Of course, no actual arrests come about. The whole system's a joke, probably provocateurs. I mean, you're noted that most people read the mainstream media, but we can't trust them to give a fair perspective.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, I mean, totally valid point, okay? Because I, like I said, I've seen things in the news and I'm like, you gotta be
Fox News is the worst. I totally agree.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But the other ones, like New York Times is terrible. And they're a prestigious newspaper.
You've got to take whatever you read in the news with a grain of salt. Yeah. It goes back to a book by, I think it was Grisham, it's called The State of Fear. And he talks about how news and media and government, how they try to install fear in people because when we're afraid, they have control. I see that, okay? But going back to the point, okay, again, I think what you guys are doing, fighting for what you believe, I think that's a positive thing. Change in the world is going to happen unless we have people doing that. It's just the method. You guys, you know, I think going there,
I agree
making
on
a statement, good job
this
on you.
This can't last forever, I agree. The question is where to next? And what do we do in the meantime? I mean, you know my perspective.
No, I know, and that's what you guys need to figure out. And while you're figuring that out, I think you really need to monitor the impact that you guys are having. Is it still the positive impact that you want to create? Or is it going in the other direction where it's actually, like I said, going to bite you guys in the ass? And you need to decide.
I mean, we wouldn't want to have another Oakland here after what happened there. And I don't think we will.
I don't think anybody wants that.
Although I think they're going to go that way in the USA. There have already been more arrests. And things are getting out of hand there. But it's an open question. I mean, at least people are having this discussion.
The problem is, and I'm sure there are a lot of great people within your group doing the right thing or doing it because they believe in the right thing, but just like we've saw in the riots, it only needs a couple of bad apples to turn things ugly. And that's what I'm concerned about. I think a lot of people are concerned about that. A lot of good people are going to get tied up in a few idiots' decisions.
You get provocateurs if they want to do something, they will. Like we saw in Quebec and in the G10 riots. Yeah, I remember. I saw the videos, guy, and the Quebec police document that explains you. We did send guys in there to beat the rocks up and get the whole union, the protesters arrested. We will see that if things get to a specific point where they're an issue, which isn't a good thing, by the way. But
what about the issue the other night, the sacred fire, and the fire department came in? That erupted into...
I read the newspaper. I was reading this morning, and they made a huge shebang out of it. I think it was Metro. It was ridiculous. Now, but that's a tough moral issue. I mean, do we stop these people? Maybe they actually need the warmth, or are they just causing trouble and not listening to the fire department? And I don't even know if the fire lines have been built. They're supposed to have lines going through it. I know I'm reading the Metro, but spare me.
There's where you can get the video from the fire. Because I recorded it the other night, my YouTube.
Without even asking or paying you or mentioning.
That's right.
CTV they just does took that. It. I'm not surprised.
Yeah, apparently a guy sold some video to CTV and they never paid him.
A different fella. Yeah.
What is
not
he gonna
me.
Do though?
No, not
he.
Yeah.
He can't take him to court. They're huge.
Well,
they actually have good lawyers.
But that's where you guys. That's what this gentleman is saying. Is try it. Do it.
Hey,
start. There's a small players court.
We need more people who know lawyers who will work. What is it? Pro bono. That's what we need.
I'm going after TELUS and the Mail, Canada Post.
You know, as long as
for two issues, and we'll have to see how it turns out.
Right.
Well, that's the
people get aggressive, and that's how they lose.
So
I mean, if you don't know your rights, it's like you don't have any rights.
But see, the thing is, from the average person on the streets,
what my case is.
When they first saw it, they go, you know, interesting, people fighting for the rights, making a point, it's great. But it is a public space, and it should be available to everybody. And now you're preventing everybody else from also using that space. So again,
reasoning right there.
No, but it's on a legal point.
These people are the public, and the public can still enter. It's not a restricted zone. People can still go in. In all fairness, you can still go in. It's a different environment.
Come on.
And let's look at the art gallery on other days. I mean, this place is.
I'm not married. I don't have kids. But I've got friends who are married with kids. And that might be somewhere where they would take their son or daughter on a weekend to play. Are they going to do that now? No.
Well,
it's not going to happen.
That's the zone up here. In a lot of other cities in the USA especially, grandparents, sons, children, daughters, all welcome. In fact, that's often on the front lines so the police don't beat the crap out of them. So it's not like we can't do it. It's just the feel of the city. I agree that's an issue. I mean, the art gallery is iconic for Vancouver. These people deserve a place, but it's one of these issues that need to be tackled.
It just goes back to my original point. I just think everybody here needs to ask themselves, at what point do we need to vacate and do this in a different way?
No, you're right. But
and by no means I'm telling anybody to stop fighting for your rights. I mean, if I've got something I believe in, I'm going to fight for it. But it's just, you know, make a point, make a statement, but then at some point you need to decide, is it time to change the way that I'm doing this?
I think you're right.
You have a voice? Do you want to share it with us? Please do.
Really, what I have to say is I think the point has been made. I think the awareness has definitely been raised. It's just I'm seeing that the actual usage and the actual, you know, the outcome that they're trying to get is starting to decline. It's just the awareness is there, but there's after that, I think after what we're seeing here today, there's just not much else you can do to get anything done.
So you agree with this gentleman, keep the message, but do it in a different way.
I think this is a more effective way of getting the message out there. I mean, it spread pretty quickly. We're just not seeing very, very much results from it.
I think in terms of politics. Yeah.
I don't think we will until something big happens, like what's going on in the U.S. Everything up here is small in comparison. We got a few hundred.
The other thing that I think would really help your guys' cause is if you had a really cohesive message.
Yeah.
Right now, it's you've got three people.
That's the tough.
You know, like salmon farms, and then you've got clear cutting, and you've got I don't know what else is in. But you've got all these little segments of people, and when you've got three people fighting for something, even though you're in a big group, their voice is really small. And the only way that you're going to be heard is if you get everybody together with a real cohesive message, and everybody has that same message, loud voice. Then people are going to notice you. But right now it seems so fragmented, and everybody looks at you guys and they're like, "What do you guys? What's the message here?
What is
the message?"
Unorganized.
But that's
see what you mean.
I mean, we're all here for different reasons.
Yeah.
A lot of us are here for debt, student debt. I mean,
so what?
I'm here for foreign policy, man. Libya was a joke, and
so
everything about that is a joke.
Get somebody from all these different factions together, and say, what are the underlying messages here? So rather than focusing on whether it's the salmon farms or deforestation or Libya, or, you know, foreign policy, whatever it might be, saying what are the messages that resonate across all of these, a common message, and pull that out,
and then fight for that.
Yeah. I think we need the banks, and that's what it all stems from, right there.
No, what this gentleman is saying is survey everybody.
Oh, yeah.
If we're going to spend money, send a survey around every house and have them pick. What are your top three beefs and bitches about?
The only message.
It's like when you're applying for a job, people tend to focus on the tasks that they do. And so they say, well, this job, I'm not really qualified for this. But if they dig a little deeper and they look at the soft skills are transferable amongst all different jobs. Things like leadership and management, etc., right? So I would say that a lot of the issues that you guys are fighting for, they have a common theme as well, but you got to dig down deep to find it. So instead of focusing on the title, look down and say, well, what is it? If it's the banks, then pull that out and make that the message rather than all these little individual things.
You're not wrong.
Because then people are, again, then it's going to be a cohesive message.
That's true.
People are going to get it.
Change our process, make it organized. And because right now, people are just thinking it's just lazy bum that don't want to work.
That's a problem.
Or it's, you know.
And that's where, again, going back, if you guys moved it off but cleaned it up, made it more organized with that message, people aren't going to think that. They're going to think, hey, this is a legitimate group with legitimate concerns. And now people are going to give you their ear and they're actually going to listen to you.
I definitely think cleaning up is the go-to. I mean, I'll be honest, I've been keeping in touch and keeping track of a lot of the other groups. Cleaning up is, of course, something that has to happen. That's a matter of hygiene. But it also does something in the matter of public perception. The question is always, where do we go from here? Where are these people going to move? And if they leave the art gallery, what kind of symbol is that?
People on my YouTube have said they've had a place before they came here. They had a place, so they can go back to wherever it was they were before. That's what the people are saying.
People say that. On the internet, people say stupid things. Like, people say the only reason you're not rich is because you didn't work hard enough. If you just work hard, you'll get out of your debt. You can buy a house in Vancouver and not have to work 30, 40 years before it pays it off because your wages are so massively outstripped. Never mind inflation, how our purchasing power has gone way down. People don't want to talk about these because people don't know about how our economy works. It all comes back to that, personally. It all comes back to the economy.
Maybe a little too personal of a question, but where did you come from?
My family was actually pretty well off. And then we lost all our money, and I learned the hard way that, you know, even with hard work and talent, it's not easy. I think I'll climb fairly high up in the social ladder if I work hard enough and if I play smart, but like I said, let's say I make 50 grand a year, when am I going to buy a house? In practice, food, a family, raising a society, my own student debt. This is a never-ending cycle, and from the 60s onward, it's only gotten worse. There is no end in sight with the economic crisis as it is, and it's going to spread further. I mean, what if the euro crashes when Greece defaults? This only looks like it's going to get worse. And I think if it does, and I hope it doesn't, then this movement will pick up even more steam. Because that's the focus in the USA. All the money's rushing out of the country. People need jobs. We don't have that issue up here. I think that's where all the movement power is going
to
come from.
So just going back to my initial question, if this packed up, where would you personally go?
I have no idea. I don't know a better place. I'm sure people have thought about it, but I'll be honest.
No, I can't. But I mean, you personally, where did you live? Where did you sleep?
Oh, I don't stay at the office.
Okay. So the point I wanted to make is, I think there's a lot of people in there who do have somewhere to go, going back to your point. There are some who have come from the streets, and yeah, they will have to go back to the streets.
That's okay. Not a good thing either.
No, it isn't. It's reality, and there still are a lot of people. I live down near East Hastings. There's still a lot of people that are on the streets. But my point is, not everybody in there has nowhere to go. Some people do have somewhere to go, like yourself. Okay, like you said, you don't actually stay in there. You're here to give a message. Okay. And if someone else is going to say, oh. In terms of banking, I worked in investment banking for about 6 years, so I know firsthand what it's like. And it was in Japan. I was over there for 16 years.
I don't know what Japan's like, to be honest.
It wasn't a Japanese investment bank. It was a U.S. investment. It was actually a German and a Swiss investment bank, and a U.S. one that's bankrupt now.
Yeah.
So I know firsthand what it's like. Not everybody who works in investment banking, but there's a lot of people. It's money, money, money. They only care about themselves, and they'll do whatever it takes in order to make the next buck.
We're feeling the consequences.
Yeah. So I know what it's like. I got out because I got tired of that culture, and I'm actually came back. I'm studying photography right now, of all things.
Well, welcome back.
But you know, so I've seen it, and I've got my own view in terms of, you know, do we need the banks? Well, they're part of the economy. Like, I don't think we can just eliminate banks, but a lot of cleanup needs to happen, and a lot of that has to come from the government. You know, government needs to take a stand on what they do. You know, too big to fail, let them fail.
Stop loaning from private banks.
But there's also an issue there. You let large corporations like that fail, people are losing jobs. You know, it's not just the people that work there, but there's a lot of other industry that's linked to banking, a lot of other jobs that's linked to banking. There are a lot of people, right down to the people that come in and clean those offices. Everybody is impacted. So it's not as simple as just saying, you know, let them fail. There's so much more to it.
Right.
But yeah, things need to change. And again, I think a message is needed. People need to stand up for what they believe in, but it just goes back to how you do it.
Yeah, it's true. Like,
that's the consensus. I think he's right, but
it's nice that you guys can have a reasonable conversation. I mean, he's got a lot of good points.
No,
you do too, but it's...
Hey, I'm learning something new.
Pardon?
I'm definitely learning something new, you know, just by listening.
What's the highlight that you've learned from
The highlight is that, you know, there's not one opinion, there's not one way to think of it. There's multiple different ways that are actually quite viable, even to think about it, just to see it, just to, you know, just ways of interpreting what's going on here. And I'm just soaking it up right now, and I'm still trying to formulate my own, but for now, this is pretty, you know, stimulating.
It is. It is.
Well, I'm glad we had the app talks like this. This is where things start.
Yeah.
Otherwise, we don't go nowhere. No joke.
Yeah, that's true. And for a while, I knew that this movement needed more to organize, because like, it seemed like a circus. No offense, but...
No, you're right.
It's just... We gotta do stuff like that, talk about it, and
it seems like the message is change, but change what? And that's what I'm having a hard time finding, is like all these things that they show on the TV and the news and everything, they say, you know, change, occupy for change, but like change what? People are very kind of abstract about that, and until you can narrow it down and have a strong voice, that it's just gonna stay the way it is now. It can't really progress any further.
Yeah. OccupyVancouver.com will help you learn about... I was there this morning and I thought, it's got some... starting to have social structure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I certainly hope so. Because, you know, it's a great car. It's a great, great idea, you know, to get out there and start change.
Yeah.
It's just, I think it's something new, and that we're still kind of finding out what works and what doesn't.
Yeah.